When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, we were like those who dream. Then our mouth was filled with laughter, and our tongue with shouts of joy. Then it was said among the nations.
Beloved brothers and sisters, again, we are glad to welcome you into the presence of God for our weekly meditation. This first Sunday of the month of September, year 2020, which is September 6, we give him all the glory for what he has done for us and for the way he continues to pilot the affairs of our lives. By the reason of the word of God, we want to encourage you that God is about stepping into the situation of your life to assure you that your life cannot be destroyed, that your life cannot be truncated. This first Sunday of the month of September, we want to assure you that our Heavenly Father has a good purpose concerning your life, and it doesn't matter where you are right now, he's going to visit you in such a way that his divine intervention will do something that will be greater than your human comprehension. How do I know this? Now, from Psalm 136, verses 1 to 3, and it says, when the Lord brought back the captivity of Zion, we were like those who dream. Then our mouth was filled with laughter, and our tongue with singing. Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for them, whereof we are glad. Because the Lord of hosts has done great things for us as his children, we are glad in this last day as we step into the month of September, this very first Sunday. Brothers and sisters, when God steps into an individual situation, everything about you changes. When God takes over the affairs of your life, people will begin to see the manifestation of God's glory in your life. And of course, by the time the children of Israel went into captivity, to be precise, God said, I have not abandoned you. Even though you have been so rebellious, you have moved against my commands for you, but then I will bring you back to the land where you are taken away from. And of course, he reassured them that he would not cease dealing with them on the note of mercy. Of course, there were prophets who said they will return earlier than God had promised. But Jeremiah told them, after 70 years, God will bring you back. And of course, 70 years may look like a long time, but in God's appointed way, he brought them back. And that is what the psalmist was reflecting on here. When the Lord brought back the captivity of Zion, we were like those who dream. Therefore, my brothers, my sisters, it doesn't matter your ugly past. It doesn't matter even your unfruitful past. It doesn't matter your unprofitable past. As long as you are saying unto the Lord, I hand over to you. He is saying, my son, my daughter, I will deal with you in such a way that you will forget the mystery of the past. And what you will do will go beyond human comprehension. Therefore, as we celebrate God's faithfulness together again this Lord's Day, I decree concerning you, God who can never lie, he will visit you in a significant way. Your sorrow will be forgotten. When we look at the pandemic for the past 4 or 5 months, people thought nothing good will come. But we have seen the goodness of God in the land of the living again. Therefore, your captivity is brought back. Whatever you thought you had lost in between February and now, before the end of this year, you will laugh again. The Lord will show you the token of his mercy. The Lord will embarrass you with splendid blessings and will begin to say, Lord, only you could have done this. I prophesy to you, your wife, your husband, your children, your parents, your entire household, this particular week, every of the 7 days, you will rejoice again. In between now and the end of the year, the joy of the Lord will be your portion. Be encouraged. He is God who can never fail. He has never failed and he will never fail. Continue to rejoice in the Lord. Be blessed. And remain with the Lord as we move on into this week. Have a blessed week in the name of Jesus Christ.